Good afternoon. We start the last part of the second day of this event. This afternoon, the presentations will be given by the students of the 27th cycle. And the first one is Marco Manfredi. You can start.
Good afternoon. I am Marco Manfredi, and I'm going to present my research topic of the first year, called Supervised Class-Specific Segmentation using One Class Support Vector Machine and Joint Kernels. A brief outline. I talked about the definition of segmentation and supervised segmentation. Then I will go into the details of our proposal, and then I will show you some experiments and conclusions. We are talking about segmentation, that is, find a partition of an image that separates the foreground from the background. And depending on the application, the foreground has a different meaning. For example, in images of horses, the foreground is the horse, and the background is anything else in the image. Supervised because the method learns what is a good segmentation with a training set of manually segmented samples with images and the mask that are manually generated. Our proposal is based on three main steps. The first is graph cut. That is a common technique in computer vision used to find the optimal partition of an image given a certain energy function. And this is an example. We have an image. Graph cut finds a binary segmentation with foreground in white and background in black that is optimal for this specific example. Joint kernels are a way to measure the similarity between an image mask pair and another image mask pair. Exploiting color feature and edge feature, we extract a value that represents the similarity between these two segmentations. Then One Class Support Vector Machine is a machine learning tool that, given a training set of example of only one class, finds a boundary between good examples and bad examples. These are called outliers and are ignored by the method. Then the One Class Support Vector Machine finds a certain number of representative examples that are called support vectors that are used to find this boundary. Putting all together, we have a training set of image mask pairs, and we compute joint kernels between each pairs of examples. And the resulting matrix is given to the One Class SVM that finds the support vector and deletes some outliers that are examples that are very different from all the others. Then it's necessary to optimize the parameters of the algorithm over a validation set. When we have a new image, we compute kernel computation with all the support vectors extracted before. And the results of this operation are two potential maps that express how each pixel is likely to be foreground or background. It's a value that connects that pixel to the foreground class or the background class. Finally, these two maps are given to the GraphCat that finds the optimal binary segmentation of the image. To clarify, this is a testing image. Computing a kernel, a joint kernel computation with all the support vectors gives us these two potential maps that, as we can see, express that the pixel on the horse are probably foreground. The grass is probably, or the sky is probably background. Given these two potential, the GraphCat finds this segmentation. These are some results on other two datasets, people, flowers, and horses. The conclusions, the proposed method is proved to be effective on these three public datasets and is faster than other state-of-the-art approaches. This is very important because the method is able to deal with datasets of even thousands of images. Another aspect is that one class SVM gives the method the robustness to deal with incomplete or incorrect ground truths at the training time. So ground truth masks that are not correct. Thank you.
Just a comment. The next time, consider not only the performance. You should consider, when you propose technique, performance versus complexity. So what you get in terms of performance and what you get in terms of complexity. And provide some numerical results.
Yeah.
That is, you get 60%, for instance, improvement in performance with a 50% reduction in complexity. For it. Okay?
Okay,
thanks. Just... Okay. So the next candidate is Mr. Nicola Capodieci.